So this is where one adventure ends and a new one begins. Figgy, the wild-caught Amazon, hailed from the San Jose area, was brought here to SoCal Parrot Rescue. SoCal Parrot Rescue was kind enough to take him in and rehab him with the other wild flock members.
The flock was released. We were able to track them today, and they joined the flock. They didn't have any problems. It was a beautiful day, and everything went perfectly.
This is our main flight. They're 16 feet wide by 60 feet long. We have Amazons that are permanently injured. Some are unable to fly, some can't be released. And they are in here as well, so they help teach the young ones how to be wild. Basically. We do supplement with pellets and a little bit of seed just to make sure they have a well-rounded diet and fruit and vegetables as well. And as much as we can from existing palm trees or any kind of flowering tree, anything that's out there that they eat, we try to bring in so they figure out that they need to, strip it down and investigate and, find their food, basically.
We want to stimulate natural behavior as much as possible.
Uh-huh.
So how do we do that and give them something to do while encouraging them to forage? We have to be really creative with our enrichment because these are wild birds, so we don't want them to get acclimated to like bird store tools.
Right.
So you have to find these ways to keep them engaged. All the Brussels sprout stalks. And so I got a couple more and put them in there last night, and this was the result of the first one.
Wow, they've shredded. It's coleslaw.
It really is.
This is where they stay, and we can watch them as they fly. This is how we choose them as well to be released. Before the release, we do psittacosis testing, and there's a couple of the tests that we actually run to make sure there's no disease and we're not anything here that's going back out in the wild. And so far, everything's been negative in all of our tests. So far, so good. Everything's been good. So we also had a camera in the flight to watch the parrots, and since this flight is so big, there's only certain spots I could put it to actually get the parrots in view. Actually not functioning right now because we're so far away from the house. Internet connection, wireless connection, and then the parrots eventually get in there and they start chewing on it, and they're parrots, and it's impossible to keep them out of those things, and they pretty much form my camera up every time.
So this is our transitional cage. Came in with broken wings, and you can see their wings are drooping. A couple are missing leg. Some have shoulder injuries, they're unable to fly, and there quite a few are, they're all from the wild, but they were adults when they came in, which is very helpful for the young guys.
We originally planned to release Figgy. We needed to find all the existing Amazon flocks in San Diego, and they spend about 6 months in the ocean communities, a place called Ocean Beach and Imperial Beach and Point Loma. And then they move out to what we call East County, which is inland, probably a good 20 miles. And that's probably from July to February. And so they stay out here and they may actually go in and nest and have their babies and fledglings. So once the fledglings are old enough to fly, they all come inland. There was 475 last time I counted. That all come into this one grove of trees, about a dozen trees, or eucalyptus and pine trees. And so we're lucky to find that, and stayed there from the time we found it to the time we had our release. It was 6 weeks, and luckily they stayed there the whole time. So we were very fortunate that it all worked out.